And then, if there's a pack, let's say 10 meters ahead of me, I'll go get them. If there's a pack 5 meters ahead of me, I'll go get them. If there's a pack of two or three or four 50 meters ahead of me,
yeah.
Let's go, let's go, let's get the emoji going down in the commas. Come on now, colon, G-O-O, colon, onward and upward. All right, I'm at the busy Main Street. As you can see behind me, the starting line is right there for the Naples Half Marathon. I'm filming this on Saturday, and one little, you know this, tip of the day, preview your race course if possible. It's not always possible. I guess the benefit of doing a road race versus a trail race is that you can drive the course. So that's what my mom and I are gonna do right now. We're gonna drive the entire course, go through the neighborhoods of Naples, just figuring out all the turns and making sure everything's in place for, well, when you're watching this Sunday morning. And it's crazy. I posted on Twitter this morning, my last peak race was the Pikes Peak Marathon, which the halfway point for that race had 7,100 feet of vertical gain to get to the halfway point. And this course has less than 100 feet of elevation change for the entire course. So we're dealing with different circumstances today. Very exciting. So now I'm gonna strap on the camera, let you see the course. I won't show you the whole thing, you know, that might get a little long, a little boring, but I'll show you some of the pieces of the course with the GoPro. All right, let's do this.
Past the 10K mark, and I am very excited. Looking at the course map, some of you have already looked at it, some of the turnaround points looked very sharp on the map. They are not, so that's good. It's a nice, easy, roundabout type of feel. Your momentum is not gonna be broken up that much when you have to. So it's basically these inlets here in the bay in Naples. So very good so far, and oh my, I just can't get too distracted by the architecture of these houses. It is it's another world in here, that is for sure. Just a couple observations in the course preview. Number one is great shade cover. Not on all the streets, but on many of the streets. Now with a 7 a.m. start, I'm not too worried about the sun too much, but you know, later in the race, by you know, 8-ish, it will be coming out for sure. So like right now, man, just really great shade cover. And great, I know this is, you think, Seth, why are you commenting about footing in a road race? Yes, I have been in some road races where the pavement has a lot of potholes, you know, a lot of uneven surfaces, and you're just running along and you actually have to look and think about your footing a little bit. And obviously it's not mountain running like I'm used to, but that is also a bonus. Like this road is just really, really nice. No potholes at all. And just a few manhole covers, but not too bad either. So just a few observations as we get ready. We're almost back to the finish line. Okay, finishing touches are all ready for the gear tomorrow. The race gear, you all know, lay it out the night before, get that bib number on the night before, unless you're picking up the bib number on race day. It just, you know, the less, I know it's crazy, the less thinking you have to do on race morning, the more you can relax, stay calm. You know that's how I am on the starting line, and even right now, like, off social media, no, and it's crazy, like, no crazy music. I like classical music. I just stay calm and try, right, keep that heart rate down. Just everything is calm from 2 p.m. on Saturday is the time right now until race morning tomorrow. So here we go, race day strategy for my first half marathon on the roads in a decade, okay? So first of all, drove the course with my mom this morning, and it's all good. It's just good. It's in my mind now. That's a key point. If you're able to do that before the gun goes off, that's awesome. Went and picked up the bib number. Everyone was awesome. Everyone at that little running shoe store was amazing. Go check them out if you live in the Naples area. And yeah, got the bit, and even the race director, the RD, kind of walked me through the course as well. That's what you saw. Well, I'll put it back up on the screen right now, so thank you for doing that. And at the end of the day, and he gave me some insights into, well, first of all, the elites start at 6:55, not at 7, so we start 5 minutes early. Glad I got that clarified. And so race day strategy. So I will, you know, I was able to get into that elite wave. I'm not sure how. Somebody made an argument for me to get in there, so that's great. But from what it sounds, it's gonna be competitive, all right? Based on the intel that I got from the RD, there's about race director, there's 25 elites, okay? I think he said 15 men, 10 women, all right? That could be flip-flopped, but I think he said 15 men, 10 women, and we're gonna go. And we're gonna rock and roll at 6:55. So, race day strategy is, oh man, there's so much to talk about. I'm just gonna walk you through, I think, all right? So, gun goes off, and I know the pace that I wanna run. I'm shooting for, you know, like, low 104s would be, based on my time from 10 years ago, that would be amazing. But based on my time from Amsterdam, about roughly 18 months ago, not quite, that would still be amazing, going from 106.53 down to the 104s. I mean, that blows my mind that I could even think about doing that. So, low 104s, I know the pace I want to hit. It's that 4.53 a mile to 4.55 a mile, 4.56 a mile, 4.58 a mile. Right under that 5 minutes a mile is where I want to live the first 3 miles of the race. Comes out to 302 to 304, 305 pace per kilometer. I'll put it on the screen for all of you. I want to live there for the first 3 miles and just make sure. So based on the race director, he said that there's some, I thought he said some Olympic hopefuls, or maybe he meant some Olympic trials hopefuls. I'm not exactly sure. At the end of the day, competitive. It sounds like it's going to be very competitive. This is great news. I'm going to be talking to guys on the starting line if they're willing to talk to me and just be like, hey, are you a 102 guy or are you a 107 guy? Like, where you want to live? Where you want? Because I want to live with you and work together most of the race. So from the start to mile three, and I have it all marked out in my mind. Mind is not go out too fast. Not like Amsterdam. Mile three, evaluate the situation, evaluate the breathing, evaluate the body, the legs. The legs feel fresh, by the way. They feel really good. They feel really, really good. After coming off of 130 down to, I just passed 30 miles today for this week. And then from mile three to mile six is when I will think about either staying there. Hopefully I'm not like saying, oh boy, this is too fast. Hopefully, it's like right there. And then if there's a pack, let's say 10 meters ahead of me, I'll go get them. If there's a pack 5 meters ahead of me, I'll go get them. If there's a pack of two or three or four 50 meters ahead of me, if I'm feeling good, I'll probably start to work up from mile three to mile six, all right? And then once we get to the halfway point, I'm still not gonna be like, okay, I'm halfway, let's go all out now to the finish. I'm going to wait till mile 9, okay? Not to start sprinting. I'm gonna wait till mile 9 to say, okay, where am I at? I know where it's at on the course exactly. Where am I at? Should I wait to mile 10 and then kick it in, meaning give it all I have the last 3 miles, or really start to feel it out those last 4 miles? So mile 9 is gonna be a really, really, actually you'll see it on Strava, I guess after the race today, what happens at mile 9. Look at mile 9 on Strava and you'll just kind of see, okay, maybe he just held steady. Maybe he felt like he needed to just ease it off a bit in order to make sure, you know, he's not redlining too early. That's also critical. But at the end of the day, I'm also a competitor, and so I want to make sure that I'm not too hesitant either, you know, and not overthinking it. Now, I want to overthink it a little bit those first 3 miles, okay? I know the pace. Amsterdam, oh man, I just learned, it was like such a learning moment, and I know you've been through that as well. And yes, question of the day, what has been, I think I've asked this before, but your biggest learning moment in a race, whether it was a positive situation or a negative situation, like Amsterdam, I just like, oh, it was rough. It was really, really rough. So there you go, and that's that. And then of course the last 3 miles, like, it's like, you know, all or nothing. I mean, the last 3 miles is just like, you get it done. You just get it done as best you can. So focusing on your form, on your gait cycle, on your arm carriage, on your foot strike, everything, that leg swing. Ooh, the leg swing, because when it starts to hurt, if you focus on your form, that's when you can overcome a little bit, not completely, but a little bit of the pain that you might be experiencing. I'm gonna stop there. We're going long. I gotta edit the vlog. I'm getting done early because I gotta, you know, go to bed. I love y'all. Let's go. Butter the bread. And I said on Strava today, like, this race is as much, you know, you're as much as part of this journey as I am. Like, you guys are just the best. DGR Strong here on YouTube, all over the place. And yeah, I mean, I hope I get to meet some of you after the race. Okay, I'll keep an eye out for people. You know, just look for me. I don't know what I'll be wearing. I'll have the singlet. I'll probably just be wearing that singlet. Well, here you go. All right, here you go. I'll just be wearing that right there, right there. All right, everyone. Thanks for being here. Thanks for watching. We'll toss it to one of the big workouts from this training block. Big workout from this training block that gives me the confidence. Tip of the day, go back to your training log. Go back to Strava. I actually go back to YouTube and I look at all the thumbnails and I'm like, okay, the work is done. Trust the training. The work is done. Trust the training. All right, we'll toss it to one of those right here, right here, right here. Woo, come on now. Onward and upward. All right, seek beauty, work hard, and love each other. See you tomorrow.